Hey, it's Jeannie from Not So Wimpy Teacher, and today on the video, I want to give you a peek inside of one of my writing notebooks, just to show you how I decided to set up the writing notebook. I have tried many different things, from three-pronged folders to spiral notebooks to binders, and this has become my favorite. I kind of combined some of the things I loved about other types of writing notebooks into this one notebook. First of all, yes, I like to use a different notebook for each genre. I do four different units, so it does mean four different notebooks. You don't have to. I find that students can fit two units in a notebook if you need to, but I do love having a different notebook for each genre. It helps my students to differentiate the different genres. They're in a different notebook. It helps them to know that there's an end. We've ended this one unit, we're starting another. So that's why I choose to do this. I do love the composition books better than the spiral, but spiral will work. I find that spiral are cheaper, so that's nice, but they get caught and they tend to break a little earlier. So you might wanna make sure you have more notebooks if you're using spiral. I loved binders because I loved dividers. What I didn't love about binders, they were expensive and they took up a ton of space. So I've created this composition notebook that has dividers. So I get the benefit of the dividers without the extra cost and bulk. So the first section of the notebook is for resources. And early on in the school year when we are setting up our notebooks, I go ahead and I let my students color their dividers and they go ahead and glue them in. We don't count the number of pages between the dividers. The first divider goes on the first page. I tell them the next divider should go about a third of the way through, and then the last one will go about two-thirds of the way through. If you have second graders or a class you just don't think could handle that, maybe get something that an aide, a volunteer, someone could help you with. I know I have teenage children, so I make them do stuff like this for me. But the resource section is really important. This is where my students keep all of their anchor charts, their graphic organizers, so that they can go back and reference them whenever they need to, when they're starting a new story, or even when we're not on this unit anymore and they're just using their extra time to write a story, I wanna make sure they can come back and review these different skills. So we go ahead and keep all of their anchor charts, and if there was any extra graphic organizers, they could always draw them on the pages in the resource section, but I wanna make sure that they have access to them. The next section is the masterpiece section. This is so important. I love the masterpiece. The masterpiece is going to be the writing sample, and we usually do two in a unit, but it's the writing sample that we are working on at the same time. We're not all doing the same prompt. We're not all writing the same thing, but we're writing it at the same pace. So we're all drafting on the same day. We're all revising our lead on the same day. We're all revising our opinion statement on the same day. We're all working on our conclusion the same day. This is the one you gotta do at the teacher's pace, because I teach a mini lesson, I give you new skills and strategies, I send you back to your desk to do it in your masterpiece. So this is a really important section. The masterpiece is usually what I grade. The next section is more stories. And the reason for the more stories section is because everyone works at a different pace. So when I gave them something to do in their masterpiece, it's gonna take one student 5 minutes and another 25. So what is the student who did it in 5 minutes supposed to do? We don't want them to move on because we wanna stay at the same pace in our masterpiece. So they always have this section back here for more stories. It has to be the same genre that we are working on. So if we're in the personal narrative unit, it has to be a personal narrative. If we're in the informational unit, it needs to be an informational. But this is where they can write at their own pace. So some of my students might be drafting a new story. Some of my students might be doing some revision, some edits. They're at their own pace back here. I don't typically grade these stories, but I'm happy if they want to share some of them in conferences, if they're proud of it. I do tell them that they ought to be using all the skills and strategies we're learning in class as they do these stories back in the back too. But I don't pay as much attention to these as I do our masterpiece. But it's for those fast finishers. They keep writing because during writing time, that's what we do. We write. So those of you who are wondering, this particular setup, the covers, the dividers, all these different anchor charts, these are part of my writing units. All my writing units include student anchor charts, all of my writing units and their lesson plans are scripted in a way that you have your masterpiece mini lesson and that students are working on a individual task every single day in their masterpiece. So I'm gonna go ahead and put a link to my writing units. I have them for grades 2, 3, 4, and 5. There are personal narrative, informational, opinion, and fiction narrative units inside of my year-long bundle. So check those out. I'll put a link in the description for you and make sure that you have subscribed to the channel so you don't miss any of my tips and strategies for making teaching just a little bit easier. Have a not so wimpy day.